lo bueno está en la superficie. Caminar. ¡Ah! ¡Aire! ¡Oh! El cielo, las nubes, el sol. ¡Oh! Oye, no lo mires.
Hola amigos, ¿cómo están? Bienvenidos. Tenemos el close-up a esta nueva película de Pixar. Así es, Luca. Luca es el nombre de la película y se estrenará a través de Disney Plus en unas cuantas horas. Ustedes se van a enterar de todos los detalles en este especial porque tenemos a las mentes maestras detrás de esta película. Vamos a platicarles algunos de los detalles que se vivieron detrás de la animación. Este es el close-up a Luca.
Hacer lo que sea, solo hay que mantenernos juntos. Somos un equipo y nos cuidamos entre nosotros. ¡Equipo!
Hello guys, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Very excited about the movie because, you know, my oldest son, his name is Luca.
You can tell him it's for, we made it for him.
We made it for him. How old is he?
It's 10. Así es, esta película habla sobre esas criaturas que cambian de forma. Esos cambiaformas que han existido en cualquier cantidad de culturas. No importa qué continente hablemos, no importa de qué país hablemos. Por ejemplo, en México están los nahuales que por años y años y décadas y mucho tiempo se ha rumorado que existen estos hombres que cambian de forma, que se transforman en criaturas por la noche. Eso ha sucedido aquí en China y en Italia también. De eso y más nos platicó el director de esta película, porque es uno de los temas principales de esta movie. Can you tell me how does this story comes from? Because we haven't seen all this environment with Italy and the monsters. And is there a specific story that you was inspired?
No, not really. It was a little bit of different elements we brought together in this kind of strange way, because I can't tell you that there's a legend that says there's a community of sea monsters off the coast of Italy. That doesn't exist. There was, you know, there's my friendship to my best friend. I knew that there was something interesting. So we were very different. We helped each other. I was shy. He was more of a go-getter. And we grew up there. And then I think the fantastical side that brought this strange spin on it, we always look for those things at Pixar, so it's not completely off the beaten path. But I got some of those ideas more off of wonderful other world folklore with changelings. You know, changelings are these kind of tricksters that can look a certain way. Sometimes it's a fox in Japanese folktales that can look like a human, or a seal like a selkie in Ireland. They can look like women. And so that's a little bit what got me thinking about, oh, I love stories when there's more than meets the eye. And as a kid, I was that kind of kid who wondered, like, well, this old lady, wait, is she a werewolf some of the times? You know what I mean? Like, I don't know what could be behind someone. So that's what got me thinking, oh, what if the kid has this big secret? The other thing that seemed interesting is that as a kid, you feel sometimes ashamed or out of place and you don't fit in. So that became an interesting metaphor for these kids who have to don't know how, what to do and have to, you know, they're curious about this other world, but they can't show themselves. So that's what seemed juicy and came together.
Sea.
Loquísimo lo que hicieron con los diálogos. ¿Por qué? Porque la gente que no sea de Italia, todos los que me estén entendiendo ahorita, and everybody that speaks in English, van a escuchar muchísimas palabras en italiano dentro de su mismo doblaje. Van a estar dobladas al español, al inglés, al chino, pero en cada uno de esos doblajes van a conservar varias palabras italianas. Así que vamos a tener que sacar el diccionario para los que no estén muy relacionados. Vamos a aprender qué significa buongiorno, buonasera, grazie mille, prego, spaghetti alla bolognesa, Mario Bros, Luigi Ducati. No, esas no. Pero sí van a aprender muchas de esas. De eso también platicamos con los creadores. About the script, about the language that they use on the movie, you mix a lot of words, the Italian words, with the dialogues, right? Why did you make that decision? Because it's always like in English, it doesn't matter in which part of the world we are seeing the characters. Now you put a lot of words, Italian words.
It was the same idea of wanting to take you there and giving you as many flavors of Italy. So in the same way that I wanted to make you feel there's beautiful music from Italy, there's beautiful cinema posters from the era, I felt it was important to immerse, or the beautiful plate of pasta. I felt that it was important to add that flavor to the language. Now, in movies, yeah, there's always some kind of a linguistic cheat logic, right? And sometimes the accent does it. But I felt like we found a way to bring as much of that flavor so you could feel there. You're right that when you actually listen to the Italian dub, you might not realize how much it was already Italian. But I'm telling my Italian friends, watch the English first, then you can watch the Italian one. It was such a pleasure. I love the language. I love languages in general. I like to learn languages. It was with a lot of pride that I shared my language. And then it was all about finding a way to make it funny, finding a way that wasn't confusing, because sometimes it could be really confusing if you don't understand it. So very often we found stupido. Okay, stupido is actually understandable very easily because it's stupid, right? So they're like a lot of cognates that help us understand it. But so it was a process as about immersion, trying to immerse you in Italian culture. Stupido!
Ahora hazlo tú, di la frase.
¿Pero qué te pasa, estúpido?
A ver, ojo, esta película viene después de Soul. Soul se estrenó específicamente online, o sea, tiene las mismas características de esta película de Luca, porque nada más se va a estrenar online en Disney Plus, igual que Soul, y Soul se ha convertido en un clásico instantáneo, y además ganó todo lo ganable. ¿Qué va a pasar con Luca? Díganos, señora productora. Esto fue lo que nos dijo Andrea. Please tell me if there's something kind of pressure. Because you have this story behind you about the Oscars, about the Golden Globes, about the successful of the movies behind of this one. How do you feel with this with this shadow? I don't know if it's a pressure or it's a motivation. How do you take it?
Yeah, there's definitely a high bar at Pixar because of the success of our films. And some of that success has translated into awards over time, for sure. So I think we all have an awareness of that. But, you know, I mean, I think some of the most wonderful moments are when you hear back from the audience about something that was meaningful to them or something that, you know, was a part of a meaningful moment in their life or that kind of a thing. I mean, we make our movies, we try to make the movies we would want to go see ourselves, and then we release them into the world and we hope other people want to see them too. And that's really the big moment. That's really the thing we wait for and hope for, is to hear back, you know, that people liked it, cared about it, related to it. And you really do hear some phenomenally beautiful stories about the meaning that it can have for people. And that's the most amazing thing you could ever hope for, I think.
Hey, ¿me la pasas?
Alguien tuvo mucha suerte hoy.
Yeah, and Pixar always has these amazing messages. Which could be the main message of this movie for the kids and for all the family?
Yeah, it's been hard for us to sum it up in one, so because there's a few. But I will say, yeah, there's something about the power of friendship to bridge all our differences in many ways, right? What is friendship? Friends really see us, embrace all of us, help us find ourselves and really show all of ourselves. I feel that it is really at the heart of it, and that, you know, without them, we might not be our full self. We might not be able to go into the world and really chase all the things we want. So I think that is the one that I think is at the center for me.
Suban.
Creen su propio club de llorones.
Me llamo Julia Marco Baldo. Los relegados nos cuidamos entre nosotros.
¿Qué es un regado?
Yeah, and about you name it 2 minutes ago about the soundtrack. You put an amazing soundtrack with mixing very very big songs and very local songs.
Yeah.
How is that process to choose the right one?
Yeah, it was so much fun. I loved the 1950s songs, and that was one of the big reasons to put it in that period. Italian songs, they're a bit of a mix of American influence and Italian. They felt very summery to me, and a good summer movie with kids, I think there's a history of, like, you know, think of Stand By Me and the beautiful songs of that movie. I think when in the summer there's always a soundtrack, there's always a radio on. So we knew that was important. We wanted to bring real songs, and then we wanted to bring you the emotions of a beautiful score. And even with our composer, Dan Romer, he knew he had to play around the opera and you know, pop songs of the 50s, but then he really brought this emotional side to it, a dramatic side when we needed it. And he also allowed Italian beautiful score to influence him. So we listened to a lot of Nino Rota, the Fellini movie score. And so that was really wonderful, like getting Dan's beautiful style mixed with the Italian style. And he lends such emotional big moments that I love how he scored the movie. I just feel a lot of emotion with his score.
Andrea, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Enrico, grazie mille.
Bien, ahora agárrate.
Pues ahí lo tienen, muchachos, ya se va a estrenar dentro de muy muy poquito. Y ustedes díganme por favor qué les parece cuando ya le echen un ojo. Mientras tanto, vámonos que aquí espantan. Yo soy Alex Montiel, pásenla chido y nos vemos en el cine. Bye.